Hi guys, welcome back to Eduvet channel. So today's video is all about euthanizing agents. So we are very familiar with the term euthanasia, and we have heard the term euthanizing agent in our clinical veterinary life. So what is euthanasia? What are euthanizing agents? When all we can euthanize an animal? What are the procedures to be taken whenever we are going to select a euthanizing agent, and what all we have to remember in euthanasia? So please subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon for more updates. So euthanasia, it's actually the term good death, is an act of inducing humane death. It's not human death, humane death. It is the process of killing an animal purposefully without causing pain. So, it's the humane killing of animals by a veterinarian. Only veterinarian has got the right to do euthanasia in case of animals, upon request of the owner of the animal under specific circumstances. That can be, if at all the animal is suffering from extremely undue suffering, that is incurable diseases or extremely painful conditions. That cannot be altered into a non-painful condition. Or if at all the animal becomes unfit for the purpose of its maintenance, or if the animal becomes dangerously aggressive or rabid. In case of rabies, if at all an animal is contracting rabies, the best method is euthanasia of an animal, because rabies treatment protocol is not proper and the curing is very rare in case of rabies. So always go for euthanasia in case of rabies. So these are the list of euthanizing agents mainly used in veterinary field. So the inhalation agents are mainly carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and inhalation anesthetics that are mainly used as anesthetic agents, and we will be giving it in a higher doses, that is diethyl ether, enfluorine, halothane, isoflurane, and methoxyfluorine. So nitrogen is also an inhalation agent. So the injectable agents which are mainly used as euthanizing agents are barbiturates, chloralhydrate and its adjuvants, ethanol, and miscellaneous injectable general anesthetics. So some general anesthetics will be used as the euthanizing agents at a very higher dose. So the ideal euthanizing agent, the properties is actually they should cause death very smoothly without causing any struggling or any pain. Those agents should not produce any struggling or pain inside the animal. The agent is sure to cause death. The agent must cause death. It should not get the animal into a coma stage. First of all, they should have the power to induce death. It should be easily administrable. That is, we have to inject it or we have to make the animal inhale it also. So should be safe for the handling person. We have to very check about that. For the veterinarian who is doing the euthanasia, the drug should be safe. So should not be cause of any environmental insanitation or contamination. Yeah, we have to go for environmental pollution free techniques. So next option is inexpensive. We have to always check the cost also. So these are the agents and the mechanism of action of those agents. So in case of carbon monoxide, the neuromuscular blocking drugs combine with hemoglobin and lowering oxygen content of blood, thus respiration ceases and finally it leads to death. So carbon dioxide is actually direct depression of CNS and other vital organs, and carbon dioxide itself has got anesthetic effects. So next is hydrogen cyanide, that is actually direct inhibition of cellular utilization of oxygen. So for any cell to utilize oxygen, there are some enzymes which are needed. So hydrogen cyanide will be blocking those enzymes which help the cells to make utilization of oxygen. That leads to unutilization of oxygen and cell death. So next is inhalation agents, that they will be mainly directly depressing the CNS and other vital organs such as nitrogen, etc. So injectable agents, the main barbiturates, they will be direct depression of CNS and has got anesthetic effects. So chloralhydrate, ethanol, T61, etc. has got direct depression of CNS. So neuromuscular blocking drugs will be going for paralysis of respiratory muscles. So respiration will be a failure. oxygen content in the blood decreases, and finally that may lead to death. So moving to the route of administration, so barbiturates will be going for intraperitoneal IV or intracardiac in case of small animals. For chloral hydrate, we will be going for IV in case of large animals. Saturated solution of magnesium sulfate IV in small or large animals can be practiced. So inhalation anesthetics, either or chloroform in dogs, cats and birds or rodents. For before that, we have to pre-treat the animals with tranquilizers or any sedatives and hypnotics, etc. So carbon monoxide, that is chamber, we have to mainly use in case of dogs and cats. So ideal agent in case of large animals or small animals are mainly pentobarbital, chloral hydrate and magnesium sulfate. We have seen this different combination in chloroform or the equipoise analgesia in cohorts. So we have to mix it in 1000 ml of water and IV, direct IV, that is, or intracardiac route also we can just go for it. Respiratory failure, in rapid respiratory failure and cardiac arrest is the main death cause, and they will not be causing any muscular twitches or any spasms or any problems or any convulsions at all, will not be there. That is the main advantage of this. So warning, first of all, we have to say, if the animal is very furious or anxious animal means, we have to go for the anxiolytics or any sedatives and all. So if at all possible, we have to sedate the animal with xylazine so that the animal will be having a proper injection possibilities of the drugs, and the veterinarian who is doing the job can do this job very properly, and the animal will be slowly moving to death, and this will be clearing all the rights of the animal and it will not be getting much pain. Thank you.